Hi, my name is Kathryn Budig, and this is Ashi Budig, and we are both here to answer all the questions that you have about Aim True Yoga. Aim True means a lot to me, and it, funny enough, started with a Greek goddess and a charm. I've always really loved Artemis, who's the goddess of the hunt and the moon, and her symbolism is an arrow. And I found this prayer to her because she's supposed to support women, and I was going through a hard time. And the opening line of the prayer was, make my aim true, give me goals and the means to achieve them. And it turned into, I will be who I want to be no matter what. And I will go in the direction, as cheesy as it sounds, go in the direction of my dreams. And so I put my focus back into what do I love and what inspires me and what do I wake up and what do I feel grateful for every single day of my life. And that became Aim True. And all of a sudden you don't focus on what holds you back, you focus on what's already there. So it's a reaffirmation of who we are. I think that's what it is to Aim True, remembering what's already here. I think there are two ways to put the Aim True perspective into our practice. We can put it into the practice on our yoga mat, our physical practice, and then we can bring it into our emotional life with our relationships and work and love. Physically, what we work on in my DVD is how to physically manifest. So we do the archer sequence, and it's very pointed, directed postures. So we're getting very strong in our physical body. But then emotionally, when we step off of the mat, and spiritually, it's that ability to speak your truth and be who you are regardless of any opinions that you feel like are being pushed on you. And also, there are gonna be days where you're not happy and you're cranky or you feel like the world's against you and so much is going on, but you know, deep down, everything's okay. And everything's connected and everything's solid. And that's what it is to aim true, is to hit the bumps like a champ and take it again and again and again, because that's life. That's that aim true mentality. Don't give up, stay focused. I was a theater girl from the size of a tater tot, and I did musical theater, and one of my dance girlfriends went and did ballet and yoga for a summer in New York City and came back when we were in college, all excited, and said, we gotta do this. So she took me to his studio. First session didn't go over so well. Guy gave me lots of adjustments, thought he was trying to get fresh with me, begged me to come back. So I came back again to another teacher. Her name was Jennifer Elliott, and she was a senior certified Ashtanga teacher, and she was beautiful and fluid, and I was mesmerized by her. So I wanted to be like her. I kept going to class, felt good. All of a sudden, I couldn't wait for yoga. That was the highlight of my week. And then I decided I wanted to learn how to teach it to make money in between audition gigs when I moved to LA. And all of a sudden, it flipped around. And I decided I didn't want to audition anymore and I wanted to teach yoga. And it turned into a full-time job. My favorite yoga pose, that kind of changes. I'd have to say probably Bakasana, crow pose, because it was one of the first arm balances that I learned how to do. And I find that when you learn how to do crow pose, everything else starts to make more sense. And it's such an empowering pose, the ability to roll forward off of your feet and be on your hands, and all of a sudden you've got this new pair of legs, except for their arms. And it opens up these doors of possibilities. So you no longer look at something with fear. You go, ah, I've got crow pose. That can't be too bad. I just have to put my foot behind my head. But, you know, it starts like that. So I think crow pose is the very cute, compact, go-to inspiration posture. My advice to beginner yogi would be never give up. You're going to want to. And there's going to be moments where it's highly frustrating And I know what it feels like. I've been a beginner too, to look around and see people floating all over and think, I'm never gonna be able to do that. But the whole beauty is that this is a journey. We call it a practice. You don't do yoga, you practice yoga. There's a great Irish prayer that says, drop to your knees and be grateful that you can stand. And so I think if you keep that mentality when you're learning yoga and you don't take it so seriously and just fall down and get up and realize that this is a brand new road that you're going on and it's a road that never, ever, ever ends, then it's inspiring and there won't be judgment or intimidation anymore. You can just suit up and get your boots on and keep going. If you were to ask any of my students if there were room for humor, they would laugh. We laugh a lot in my class, and I think yoga can be taken very seriously, and I understand that because it is a sacred thing, but I think everything sacred is funny too. And I'm a strong believer that humor lightens everything. Just as the same way that saying yes as opposed to no, I can't, lightens everything. So if you can learn how to say yes and you can learn how to laugh, you can learn how to do any pose you ever wanted to do. I think yoga can definitely change the world. And I think it is changing the world. When someone gets onto a yoga mat, they learn how to slow down. And when you can get out of that constant storyboard that's being written in your head, you can start to see clearly again. And once you can start to see clearly again, you might readjust your attitude or perspective. And that can cause a whole lot of love as opposed to a fear-driven, painful place. So, yeah, yoga's changing the world, for sure.
What do you guys want to know?